Be able to say hallelujah, just knowing that he gave you another opportunity this morning, knowing that he woke you up. He clothed you in the right mind. And that should be enough just to say praise God. Let us pray. Oh gracious Father, as we come before you right now, Father God, we come with joy in our heart. Father God, for we know that you gave us another opportunity in life. And Father God, we just want to tell you thank you. Father God, we want to thank you for waking us up this morning. Father God, we want to thank you for allowing us to be able to move and have our being. Father God, we thank you for the food on our tables and the clothes on our back. Father God, we thank you for your grace and your mercy. But most of all, my Heavenly Father, we thank you for your darling Son, Jesus, who went to a hill called Calvary. He took the sins of the world and put them on his shoulder. Father God, they nailed him to an old rugged cross. Father God, and he hung there and he died. Oh, but there's a shout this morning because it didn't stop just there. On the third day, he got up with all power in his hand. Father God, and because he got up, I'm able to be reconciled back to you, and I just want to tell you thank you this morning. Father God, we just want to thank you for giving us life and us having it more abundantly. Father God, we just thank you for this opportunity that you've given us today. For Father God, there are some that wasn't able to get up this morning. Father God, there were some that wasn't able to close themselves this morning. But Father God, we don't take anything lightly. We know that, Father God, it's because of you that we are able to do the things that we do. And we just want to tell you thank you this morning. And Father God, as we come before you, Father God, we want to lift up our pastor and the first lady this morning, my Heavenly Father, that as they continue, my Heavenly Father, to go through the process, my Heavenly Father, that you have allowed them to go through. Father God, we just want to thank you, my Heavenly Father, because in spite of my Heavenly Father, you have still covered them, my Heavenly Father. You have still sheltered them, my Heavenly Father. And Father God, and we know that complete healing is on the way. And we just want to thank you this morning right now. Father God, we thank you for all of those, my Heavenly Father, in Mount Zion, my Heavenly Father, that have felt the impact, have felt the affliction of COVID, my Heavenly Father. But Father God, we know, my Heavenly Father, that you are still in control. And Father God, and right now, my Heavenly Father, we just ask you, my Heavenly Father, to just cover this church right now, my Heavenly Father, with the blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, my Heavenly Father. Cover us, my Heavenly Father, with the blood of the perfect Lamb, my Heavenly Father. Cover us, my Heavenly Father, with the blood of the ultimate sacrifice, my Heavenly Father. Father God, and we know, my Heavenly Father, that if we do just continue to cover us, my Heavenly Father, that death, my Heavenly Father, will pass us by, my Heavenly Father. Father God, we know that we will be a new creature, my Heavenly Father. We just continue to cover us, my Heavenly Father. Oh, Father God, and as I come before you right now, my Heavenly Father, I pray for my family right now, my Heavenly Father. That is feeling the effects, my Heavenly Father, of COVID. I pray, my Heavenly Father, that you just continue to strengthen them, my Heavenly Father. Continue to lead and guide, my Heavenly Father. Father God, I know that there are some that say that they couldn't wait for 2020 to be over and was ready to usher in 2021. But Father God, that you have let us know, my Heavenly Father, that it doesn't matter whether it's 2020 or 2021, my Heavenly Father. We still have to call upon you, my Heavenly Father. We still have to lean and depend upon you, my Heavenly Father. And Father God, I'm a living witness that you said that if we just call upon you, you will answer. And I come calling on you this morning, my Heavenly Father, for healing of this land, my Heavenly Father. Oh God, as we watch those took the things that I told him the other day, my Heavenly Father, at the Capitol, my Heavenly Father. Father God, we know even more, my Heavenly Father, that we need you, my Heavenly Father. But we can't depend upon man, my Heavenly Father, because man will let us down, my Heavenly Father. But you say that you will never leave us, nor forsake us. And we just come, my Heavenly Father, calling on you right now, my Heavenly Father, that you would just heal this land, my Heavenly Father. Oh God, my Heavenly Father, we know, my Heavenly Father, that there are those that ain't no White House, my Heavenly Father, that don't know you, my Heavenly Father. We know that there are those that ain't no White House, my Heavenly Father, that feel that they have all the power, my Heavenly Father. We know that there are those in the White House, my Heavenly Father, that feel that no matter what they say, my Heavenly Father, that it is going to come to pass. But Father God, I know, my Heavenly Father, that you're the one that spoke everything into existence, my Heavenly Father. Father God, and it says in your word that in the beginning was the Word, my Heavenly Father. And the Word was God, and the Word was with God, my Heavenly Father. We know, my Heavenly Father, that nothing can be done, my Heavenly Father, without you, my Heavenly Father. Nothing can be done without your Son, Jesus Christ, my Heavenly Father. And Father God, and we're just so happy that you left us a comforter, my Heavenly Father, to comfort us during these trying times. Father God, again, we just pray, my Heavenly Father, for healing right now. Healing of this church, healing of this community, healing of this land. And Father God, we say amen, my Heavenly Father. We bless you, my Heavenly Father, as you continue to bless us. Father God, it is in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, that we pray. And we pray in his name. And we all say amen. Our scripture for this morning is going to come from Psalm 31. Psalms 31. And it is a psalm of David. David is pleading to God for protection. And we're going to read stanzas 1 through 19. When you have it, say amen. Psalm 31. And it reads, in thee, O Lord, do I put my trust. Let me never be ashamed. Deliver me in thy righteousness. Bow down thine ear to me. Deliver me speedily. Come, Lord, come quickly. Be thou strong. Be thou my strong rock for an house of defense to save me. For thou art my rock and my fortress. Therefore, thy name's sake, lead me and guide me. Pull me out of the net that they have laid quickly for me, for thou art my strength. Into thy hand I commence my spirit. Thou hast redeemed me, O Lord, the God of truth. I have hated them that regard lying vanities, but I trust in the Lord. I will be glad and rejoice in thy mercy, for thou hast considered my trouble. Thou hast known my soul in adversity, and hast not shut me up into the hand of the enemy. Thou hast set my feet in a large room. Have mercy upon me, O Lord, for I am in trouble. Mine eye is consumed with grief. Yea, my soul and my belly, for my life is spent with grief, and my years with sighing. My strength faileth because of my iniquity, and my bones are consumed. I was a reproach among all my enemies, but especially among my neighbors, and a fear to my acquaintances. They that did see me without fled from me. I am forgotten as a dead man out of mind. I am like a broken vessel. For I have heard the slander of many. Fear was on every side while they took counsel together against me. They devised to take away my life. But I trust in thee, O Lord. I said, thou art my God. My times are in thy hand. Deliver me from the hand of my enemies and from them that persecute me. Make thy face to shine upon thy servant. Save me from thy mercy's sake. Let me not be ashamed, O Lord, for I have called upon thee. Let the wicked be ashamed, and let them be silent in the grave. Let the lying lips be put to silence, who speak grievous things proudly and contemptuously against the righteous. Psalm 19 says, oh, how great is thy goodness, which thou hast laid up on them that fear thee, which thou hast wrought for them that trust in thee before the sons of men. God bless you. It's always my prayer.
Thank you.
Truth is, we all need Jesus. We need a Savior to save us from this world. The biggest question now, how do we take advantage of the shutdown spiritually? One of the blessed benefits of the cross, when you're saved, you can start all over again. At times, life surprises all. But the shout this morning, nothing ever surprises God. The Bible declares there's nothing new under the sun. Even when times change, our God never changes. Scripture says Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
And brothers and sisters, I'm glad about it this morning. I knew it was cloudy and a little windy. The forecast called for rain, but God never leaves us, nor he forsakes us. And David said, if I ascend to heaven, thou art there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, thou art. Aren't you glad that God is always with us, brothers and sisters? I don't know about you, but you know, 10, 11 months, I preached to nobody, to any of the church. So if you don't help me out this morning, that's all right. I'm going to shout myself happy. In the text, Jesus did not give his disciples no options when it comes to following him. There are no options when it comes to a restart spiritually. Yeah. There are times spiritually we have to deny ourselves and take up our own cross and follow Jesus. Our whole life should be centered around God and the things of God. Our commitment to Christ and our Christianity must be absolute. Mm. Brothers and sisters, we quarantine everything but sin. We quarantine our worship. We quarantine our office. We quarantine our time. But we quarantine everything but sin. Isn't it about time that we start repenting and giving our life to Christ? I don't know about you. Too much senseless things going on right now when we need to be prostrate, laying before our Savior, calling on his name. Too much senseless crime in Donaldsonville. Too much senseless politics in the White House. Too much senseless hate and racism going on in the world. I believe we need to call on the name of Jesus. Is there anybody this morning can call his name? Our relationships should be absolute. You know, I got a question for y'all. Who can make things better? Who can help us this morning? Y'all don't know anything about Jesus? Am I the only one that knows that Jesus is the only one can help us this morning? Who has the power to change things? Brothers and sisters, nobody but Jesus. They used to say, on Christ, the solid rock I stand, and all other ground is sinking. Jesus must be first at all times and everything in the real, true believer life. Brothers and sisters, it's time we can't think Christianity no more. Whose side will you be on this morning? Are you on the Lord's side? God is calling the believers and the body of Christ on the carpet. Many follow Jesus, but only a few take up his cross. Many shout Jesus, but only a few take up his cross. Many are kneeling, but the question this morning, how many really are praying? How many really are seeking a Savior? How many really trusting in God that he's going to bring us out of this time? With the cross, the believer has a new obligation. Paul plainly stated, he said it clearly, I'm determined to know nothing among you except Jesus Christ and him crucified. It is about time that we start witnessing and testifying about how great of salvation we have. Anybody glad that they're saved this morning? Anybody can shout about their salvation? Can anybody thank Jesus that he died on the cross at Calvary for their sins? Can anybody testify how good the blood has been in their life? I don't know about you, brothers and sisters. Every time I think about what God has done in my life, I can't help but to shout. Took a young man out the streets of Donaldsonville. They said he never was going to be nothing. But what God said, that's all that matters in our life. Brothers and sisters, I'm glad this morning that he's still saving. And we need to tell our brothers and sisters, we need to witness to people, the only thing this world can't take from you is your salvation. It's a blessing to be saved. We ought to be thankful that we're saved. We ought to be glad that we're going to a place not made with man's hands. It's about time, brothers and sisters. It's about time that we get about being and stay about staying connected to the kingdom. It's about coming alive to the things of God. Jesus wasn't being disrespectful when he told his mother, I must be about my father's business. It is time that we get about our father's business. The world looks like it's caving in on us, but God is still good. It's about time we be about our father's business. They used to say, it's getting late in the evening and the sun is going down. But I guarantee you, it's still time to be about our Father's business. During the stay-home order, even when the country opens back, our focus should be on Jesus Christ and Him crucified.
Yes, Lord.
It should be about Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like me.
Yes.
God sent Jesus, His only Son, to die for us.
Yes.
Watch this. Not because we was good enough, but because He loved us.
Yes.
Brothers and sisters, one of the main ingredients to shout for during your salvation, for your salvation, that you are loved. Isn't it good to know that somebody loves you?
Yes, Lord.
And see what I love about God, love, it don't twist or turn. It doesn't matter where you are in life, God still loves you.
Yes.
You see, we're not offering the real deal salvation to people. See, we got to tell them that God loves them. Saints, sinners, and seekers, God loves you. We can't beat them up about their sins. We got to tell them that God loves them. And God loves us so much, the Bible says He forgive our sins, for us the east is the west.
Yeah.
And see, we have to come to the final analysis, and the conclusion is about getting people saved.
Yeah.
We need to be bringing many people we could into the kingdom.
Yeah.
Look. See, the problem is we forget where we come from.
Yeah.
And we start looking down on these young black men and women in the streets, and we forget that we have skeletons in our closet. But thank God by saving grace that He forgave me. So what you're saying, brethren, that I can forgive others. Why does God bless us so we can bless others? Why did He extend mercy to you so you can extend mercy to others? He had to get on Peter. He said, Simon, the devil desires to have you. He desires to sift you as wheat. But when thou art converted, but when Minister Mayor Leroy gets saved, when Brother Lawrence gets saved, I pray for you that you strengthen your brothers. We forget the purpose of the cross. We forget the purpose of salvation. Our purpose is to be a testimony and a witness to others. Is there anybody love telling other people what God has done in their life? Are you ashamed of the gospel? Are you ashamed to tell people about Jesus?
Yes.
He said, if you're ashamed of me on earth, if you're ashamed of me now, when I get to my Father's house, I will be ashamed of you. Brothers and sisters, He died for us. He went to carry for us. But He said there's also another cross that man has to bear for himself daily. You know what I love about cross? Your cross just made perfectly for you. See, the problem with brothers and sisters, the problem with Christians, we always rubbernick it. Look, what I look like with me a cross on my back. I'm a short, kind of teeny tiny little man. You think I can carry Mayor's cross? Your cross is perfectly designed for you. And God expects from you what only you can do. Somebody say, well, I can't be this, that, like this, and that. God didn't ask you that. You see, be the best you. Be great with what you have. Don't you know that God has given us enough to be successful in whom we are?
Yeah.
Why? Because He made us. Brothers and sisters, another old song He used to sing, must my Jesus bear the cross alone and all the world go free. There's a cross for everybody. There's a cross for you and me. Starting over and going forward, there's no option. This is how we are going to react. We have to start exalting our Savior to the highest. For the price He paid to set us free. We have to learn how to exalt Jesus. We have to magnify our risen Savior. We're going to live for Jesus. Going forward, we have to love like Jesus. Jesus' love is forgiving. Jesus' love is forgiving. Jesus' love is patient. Jesus' love is giving. Jesus' love is long-suffering. Jesus' love is everlasting. It never runs out. Brothers and sisters, it's obvious. We're looking at the world. We can't lose when Jesus is first.
Yes, Lord.
We can't lose when God is on our side. Jesus said, everyone that had forsaken houses, brethren, sisters, fathers, mothers, wife, children, lands, for my name's sake, shall receive a hundredfold inheritance and everlasting life. Yeah. Brothers and sisters, but many that are first shall be last.
Yeah.
But the last shall be first. And that's a shout this morning. Oftentimes we look like we're down, but we gotta wait till our first come around.
Yeah.
We gotta decide on whom we will serve. Joshua said, as for me and my house, we gonna serve the Lord. See, the shout this morning, too many of us focus on the elephant and the donkey. But you got to make a choice spiritually. Who you gonna serve? Who you gonna cast your vote on? Reverend Julian decided to cast his vote with Jesus. Jesus is my trust. Jesus is my strength.
Yeah.
Jesus is my joy. Yeah. Jesus is all I have.
Oh,
and brothers and sisters, when you're last, you don't have to get in a hurry. We just have to wait on God because our time is coming.
Yeah.
I heard you, Isaiah, they that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. We have to not leave without God. What you saying, Pastor? Don't go on your own.
Yeah.
We have to go with God because the shout this morning that he can reverse any curse.
Yeah.
And I'm glad this morning that the pandemic days are numbered.
Yeah.
Because why? God can recondition any position.
Yeah.
See, God allowed this test because he still is in control.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah. And I don't mind being last right now as long as I'm last with Jesus.
Yeah.
But see, when the first comes around, what I'm going to do until the first come around, I'm going to praise him every chance I get.
Yeah.
See, a lot of people wait till the battle is over to shout to Jesus.
Yeah.
But we have to learn to praise him anyhow.
Yeah,
I want to know if you got an hallelujah anyhow.
Yeah.
See, the scripture said, in everything, give God thanks.
Yeah.
Not for, but in.
We
might be in the midst of a pandemic, but I can say thank you.
Yeah.
In the midst of bad politics, I can say thank you. Don't know what the stimulus is going to do, but I can still say thank you. See, a lot of people hurt right now, but can you still say thank you? Brothers and sisters, secondly, our commitment to Christ going forward must be constant and consistent. See, self-denial is a key to spiritual restart. See, Jesus needs our full attention.
Yeah.
Not the virus, not the politics, the news, or the social media. Not even a pigeon with a note. But Jesus needs our full attention. Jesus has been totally loyal to us. But he wants us to be totally loyal to him. And the people and things he blessed us with. See, a restart, we have to be loyal to our family. We have to be loyal to our church. We have to be loyal to our ministries. We have to even be loyal on our job. But most of all, we have to be loyal to our Savior. See, God wants our hearts totally. Nothing should be placed above our commitment to living for Jesus. Y'all heard that? Nothing should be above our commitment to live for Jesus. The question here, are you all in this morning? Have you given your all to Christ?
Yeah.
Do you really trust him like you should?
Yeah.
Do you believe God is your all in all?
Yeah.
I hear you more than why, though trials may come on every hand.
Yeah.
How many still feel like going on?
Yeah.
How many feel like they're going to make it with Jesus?
Yeah.
How many can trust Jesus? How many ready to bear their cross this morning?
Yeah.
See, brothers and sisters, one of the good spiritual side effects of the pandemic, Satan has exposed can't hide in the church no more.
No.
People looking for the real deal.
Yeah.
Now know what the real deal is. The real deal is when you leave on Sunday, you don't change on Monday.
Right.
Wait. When you leave on Sunday, you don't change on Sunday afternoon.
Yeah.
People looking for real words,
yeah,
in season and on time. People are looking to see, to hear if there's a Savior. People are looking to hear if there's some help. People are looking to hear if there's some direction. What direction is? The Bible says, if I look up to the hills, from whence my help coming from? Where our help come from? Our help comes from the Lord. See, the truth be told, Jesus is looking for real Christians. He say, I'd rather you hot. Not, you shouldn't be hot nor cold, but I'd rather you to be one way, he said, because if you're lukewarm, I'll spit you out of my mouth.
Yeah.
See, brothers and sisters, we have to be one way when it comes to God.
Yeah.
When it comes to bearing your cross, you have to be the same way all the time.
Yeah.
Too many saying one thing and doing another.
Yeah.
Too many Christians walking around in doubt. Jesus said the hour coming.
Mm-hmm.
And now is when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and truth.
Yeah.
We all in a position where we can't fake it.
No.
Do you still have a word? Can you still testify?
Oh, yeah.
Can you still preach? Can you still sing? Brothers and sisters, can you still pray?
Oh, yeah.
Restarting, bearing our cross, going forward.
Yes.
We should all be better physically, mentally, materially. We should have took advantage of this shutdown.
Mm.
Exercising. Meditation.
Yeah.
Everybody should have some extra dough.
Yeah.
Our spending should have been cut tremendously. We ain't had nowhere to go to spend it at. Spiritually, in a lot of our areas, we should be better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Our Christianity should have ratcheted up some notches.
Yeah.
Our prayer should have gotten stronger,
yeah,
deeper,
yeah,
and more intimate.
Yeah.
I don't know what 2021 will bring,
no,
but I trust you, Lord.
Trust
Lord, make me better.
Yeah, please, Lord.
Increase my faith. I'm praying, y'all.
Yeah. Yeah.
Give me a heart of compassion. Give me a will to still worship. Give me a will to serve. Escape me in the deep treasures of your word. Teach me more to be like you, Jesus. Remind me it's not about me, but it's about you, Lord. Strengthen us where we are weak. Pour out your spirit on us, Lord. Pour out your love. Pour out your mercy. And extend your grace. God, make it better. Help me to bear my own cross daily. Finally, brothers and sisters, our commitment to Christ is trusting in Him and the finished work of the cross. It's evident with this new normal, we can't do it on our own. The spiritual restart, we have to have divine backing. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. 2021, pledge of faith. I'm committed to God. He's the author and the finisher of my faith. See, that's good news because we don't have to worry about F-A-T-E. Because God is in control. Can I get a shout right there?
Yeah.
God is in control. See, God is not the author of confusion.
No, He's not.
Because we have faith. Politics Because God give us divine backing. Scripture says he ascended on high and led captivity captive. The good news is whatever got us, God got it. Brothers and sisters, he says he prepares a table in the presence of my enemies. The virus has been a deadly enemy, but we still eating. We still shouting. We still worshiping. He said in his word, no weapon that is formed against us shall prosper. God won't let our enemies prevail. This virus, days is numbered. Why? He said, on this rock, I'm going to build my church. And the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Divine backing, all things work together for the good of them that love the Lord. If it's not God, if it's not good, then God is still working. Jesus said, in the world you should have trials and tribulations. But be of good cheer, because he's overcome the world. We overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. Not only we are survivors, but when we bear our cross, we become overcomers. And I'm looking out here in this audience, I see a bunch of overcomers. Brothers and sisters, divine backing, nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors. Success comes from taking up your cross and following Jesus. The restart, second Sunday, 2021, invest in Jesus. Put some stock in your cross. The promises of God are yes and amen. And whatever God promised, he will perform. And when you follow Jesus, Jesus' blessings will follow you. Brothers and sisters, as I come to a close, we ought to take time to work on our cross. Make a conscious effort to do better, to be better. Make a conscious effort to extend salvation to those that are lost, mercy to those that are hurting, grace to those that are in need. Because we can testify, if we obey God and keep his commandments, the Lord will bless us. And what I love about bearing the cross, following Jesus, the more I give, the more I receive. But 2021, it ain't all about prosperity. The more I want, the more I give, the more I receive, the more I want of Jesus. I got a question for you as I come to a close. How many want more of Jesus? How many really want more of Jesus? See, brothers and sisters, when you have more of Jesus, the Bible says he'll open up the windows of heaven and pull you out a blessing. What is a blessing? You say you don't want the prosperity. Is there anybody in the house who want healing? Want peace? Is there anybody in the house that wants joy? Is there anybody in the house that wants their family covered? Is there anybody in the house that wants racism to end? Is there anybody in the house that wants bad politics? Is there anybody in the house that wants this pandemic to end? Is there anybody in the house that wants things better? I don't want to know about you, but anybody in the house that wants this vaccine to end? Is there anybody that God, thank you. You've been so good to me, thank you. You brought me from a mighty long way, thank you. You healed my body, thank you. Keep on blessing me, thank you. Thank you for my family. Thank you for my preaching brothers. Thank you for the churches. Thank you for the musicians. Thank you for the ushers. I don't know about you, I miss my church. Don't know who I'm gonna see in 2020.
By God. You're made in His image and likeness.
where you come. If you're watching, Minister Leroy, Pastor Smith, this great church, always available. Whether you need prayer, they're here for you to witness, to pray for you. Stop putting off for tomorrow. Every day on the news, tomorrow has to come for many. Give it to Jesus. Give your life to Jesus. Put it in His hand. Give it all to Jesus. God bless you. Thank God. Before we take the Lord's Supper, can we go to the throne? Eternal God, our Father, certainly we thank you. We thank you for the price you paid for our sins. We thank you for the liberty that you have given us. We thank you for kingdom living and relationship. God, we just thank you for your awesomeness, the indwelling of the Holy Spirit, strength and weakness. Father, we thank you for this great pastor, Pastor Smith. We lift him up. We lift his family up. We lift his church family up. God, bless him in a mighty way. Scripture says, by your stripes we are healed. We declare healing. Spiritually, physically, emotionally, and mentally. We declare healing for this city, our community, our country. Father, we bless your name. We thank you for the privilege to be able to carry our own cross. We thank you for the blood you shed on Calvary, that it cleanses us and washes us. Makes us whole. God, we renounce Satan and we pray for forgiveness for every sin. Make us worthy before we partake in your holy ordinance. Bless the people watching. Bless those on the sound of our voice. Lord, we love you. We thank you. And we praise you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and thank God. Amen. Amen.